Our test speaker is none other than Robert Lam with his speech title, Welcome to Bali. Welcome to Bali, Robert Lam.
The story is told about an elderly couple who came back from a night in town. The husband starts to pack his bags. The wife asks, "Where are you going, darling?" The husband says, "I'm going to Bali. You know, every time you make love there, they give you $10.
Really?
Now the wife starts to pack her bags. The husband asks, "Where are you going, darling?" The wife says, "I'm going to Bali too. I want to see how you're going to survive on $20 a year." Contest chair, honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen, this is not the reason why my son and I decided to fly up high in the sky to the valleys of Bali. We were on a holiday come business trip. I stayed in a place called Matahari Bungalow. My tour guide called it Matahari Bungalow. The friendly hotel people called it Matahari Bungalow. Therefore, I have got no doubt about the pronunciation, Matahari Bungalow. Now, Matahari I understood perfectly well, the sun. But Bungalow, could it be some sort of flower? A few days later, I discovered how Bungalow was spelled. I needed to rent a small conference room to conduct a meeting in Matahari Bungalow. Now I was smart. Before I communicated with the friendly hotel people, I took out my Indonesian English dictionary. Small room. Room. Kamar. Small, kecil. So small room means kamar kecil. I went up to the counter and I asked them for kamar kecil. The friendly hotel people brought me straight to the toilet. What a fudge cake, I thought. Then he showed me the signage, man, woman, kamar kecil. Toilet information. Ladies and gentlemen, I was learning very fast. But there's some unique things I noticed in Bali. In KL, if you look on the road, almost every car you see is either a Myvi or a Proton. In Bali, almost every vehicle you see is a Toyota Kijang. You look to the right, Kijang. You look to the left, Kijang. You look behind, Kijang. You look up, no Kijang. The Balinese, they speak very highly of their mobile. They say their mobile is very good. Their mobile is trustworthy. Their mobile is reliable. So in my mind, I visualize that Exxon Mobil must be a very big conglomerate in Bali. I imagine that Exxon Mobil must be creating hundreds of job opportunities for the Balinese. However, everywhere I went, I did not see any Mobil, Esso, or Caltex. All I saw was Pertamina. From the back seat of my car, I asked my tour guide, "Where is this Mobil that you speak highly about?" He said, "You are sitting in one." An Indonesian car means Mobil. In KL, when you are driving, if somebody honks at you, he's most likely irritated with you and he's scolding you. In Miri, Sarawak, if somebody were to horn at you, he most likely knows you and he's saying hi. In Bali, everybody horns at everybody. Confused, I asked my tour guide, "Do I drive on the left or the right of the road?" He said, "Both." First you start on the left,
unless it's already occupied.
Then you move to the right.
Unless it's occupied too. Then you find the next available gap and you just enter inside.
Like playing chess.
Fatherhood is another thing that I'm very proud about. I became a father at the age of 31. I had to get married in order to become a father. In Bali, you don't need to get married to become a father. You don't even need to have a child to become a father. They call everybody their papa or pa. So automatically, you're upgraded to fatherhood. Ladies and gentlemen, Bali is a mystical land full of mysticism and spiritualism. They pray to the gods, they pray to the spirits. That is their dogma. I asked my tour guide, why isn't Bali affected by tsunamis and volcanoes? His answer is very simple. We pray to the gods, we pray to the spirits. That is our dogma. If that is your dogma, why don't you pray for world peace? I challenged him. He answered my question by telling us a story. He said, once upon a time, there was this monk who was driving his kijang in Bali. Suddenly, a black dog crossed the road. The monk banged into the dog. The dog died. Overcome with remorse, he looked and he saw a temple. He knocked on the golden gates of the temple. Another monk opened the door. The first monk said, I am terribly sorry. My karma ran over your dogma. Back to you.